Hi, this is John Burek with PC Mag. I'm here with Dell and Alienware, and we're looking at a concept device here. This is what's being called Concept Polaris. So Concept Polaris is a sort of a rethinking of Dell's and Alienware's external graphics card box. So the original Alienware graphics card box was called the Graphics Amplifier, and for many years it was available for Alienware laptops and used a proprietary interface to connect to different Alienware machines. This is a rethinking of the concept. Let's take a look. In removing the power supply from inside the chassis, Alienware has created more space inside the eGPU now. They're using external power adapters that go into the wall outside of the chassis itself, which gives them more room to innovate inside. So in this particular box, Alienware tells us that they have put a RTX 3090 card, and this can take pretty much any card on the market in terms of length. But we're going to take a look inside this box in a moment, and you'll see why there's actually more to it than just that. So here we have the chassis up on end, and one thing I should point out is that you saw before that this was lying down on one edge. They've also designed it so you could stand it up. So in opening this up, you can see that we have a full-length GPU in here, but that's actually not even the biggest reveal here. When you turn it around, you'll notice that they've actually managed to liquid-cool the GPU inside of this chassis. So not having the power supply inside of the chassis actually enabled Dell to do that, which you wouldn't have been able to do if you had a large power supply block in here. Now, whether it's going to be practical or much of a benefit to liquid-cool a GPU in an eGPU, because there are other limitations on eGPU performance, such as the CPU and the laptop that you attach to, remains to be seen. You might be asking, why would you liquid cool an eGPU? After all, you're going to be limited by the CPU's capabilities and also by the sort of other factors that come into eGPU connectivity between the eGPU and your laptop. One of the things that Dell is pointing out here, though, is that with this kind of design, you'll be able to overclock your GPU. So if you have a lesser GPU, you'll be able to get a little more juice out of it. If you have a maximum possible GPU, like a 3090, you might be able to get a little more performance out of it based on the liquid cooling technology you have here. And not only the actual liquid cooling gear you have here, as a whole solution, Dell is including, or Alienware is including, use of its liquid metal thermal interface material between the GPU and the cold plate on the GPU to enable better overclocking. So being able to do that in an eGPU is something that just really isn't out there right now, and what makes this concept kind of interesting. So let's take a look around the other side of it. On the bottom side here, you can see that this can also be used as a docking station, as most eGPUs these days can be. You have multiple USB ports, you have the outputs for the video card down here, and there's also a separate power brick here for other elements of the eGPU. Again, just a concept design, but the idea here being you have a cover here, you snap it on, you have your cables running through the side of it here, and you'd have your display cables and other peripherals sort of permanently attached, say, to your monitor and to your, you know, keyboard and mouse setup for gaming. So you could orient this thus vertically, you know, like so, or lying down like you saw before, like this. So what we have here is a Concept Polaris, and one other important point around this is the connectivity to the PC. Now, Dell is looking to various ways of connecting your eGPU to your gaming laptop. Currently, this design is using Thunderbolt 4. Earlier Alienware eGPUs used a proprietary connection, as I mentioned before, to Alienware laptops. It only worked, therefore, with Alienware laptops with that proprietary connection. So the eGPU space is going to be moving towards, obviously, Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4, it already has. And this here is a concept design for liquid cooling your eGPU inside of a much roomier case than other models on the market.